What? So you had sent me some issues that you want to focus on. So I have acne, insomnia, and a possible relocation or move. So is there a specific one you want to look at first, or do you want me to just go into them and see what comes?
I'm pretty open. I'd like to just see what
Okay.
comes
All
forward.
right. Sounds great. I'm going to take a minute to connect and then I'll dive in and see what we can explore.
Great.
Okay. Okay, so for the acne, I feel like it's inflammation. It feels like that's the signal. That's like the visible signal that you'll pay attention to when you have inflammation in your body, where the other ones you can ignore or you have ignored. And this is just like one of the things that just, it's just your body telling you, hey, look at me. And like, yeah, there, the inflammation is definitely torso based. Let me see. Like I feel like it kind of resonates out. Like I kind of feel it, like I feel it starting to like affect like knees and just like more of the lower part a little bit more. But like it's just like glaring in the torso. Let me just see.
Like the digestive system.
Yeah, like yeah, between the hips and the lungs, that area. I kind of feel more in there. Like from the like right here down, like the nipple line down, is where it's kind of like the most obvious for me. I'll just dive into it more and explore a little bit.
Yeah, I'd like to know like the source of like why is there inflammation?
Okay, so when I'm asking about the source, like first thing popped in my head was fear. It feels like it's holding on to fear. It's holding on to emotions. It's fear of letting go. It's fear. It's just like I feel like just gripping this, just like closed fist, just holding on and pulling. Let me just kind of dive a little further. Okay, so it feels like there is some past life connection, but it's a bigger connection to generational. Let me see, which one do I want to address first? Let me see. So generational, and it's pulling me down the female line like instantly.
Wow.
Let me see. Yeah, and there's like a lot of like, oh yeah. Fear of change, fear of letting go, fear of just being unsteady and uncomfortable in your body, being like just feeling unsafe. I feel a lot of unsafe in your skin, unsafe, unable to let the guard down. That's the energy down the generational line. Let me see. Like it feels like it started a long time ago and it's just been carried on unconsciously without oh and it's in my throat too. It's unable to speak up, share, just falling in line and doing what you're supposed to do. And like being really, really unsafe. Like it feels like down the line there was like it feels like domestic abuse or just or unsafe to be who you are. You either society or family is putting you in a box and making and forming it so packed and so tight, there's no wiggle room. And it's just that energy has pulled through. Okay, let me just see what I can do to work through this. A lot of, well, feels obvious to me, but forgiveness of that line, forgiveness of where that position of where those women were, and giving them lots of love and a lot of gratitude for making the line possible for you to be who you are now. Because they're responsible for you being here. So even though they have brought that line and that energy to you, you wouldn't be here experiencing life without them. And also, I feel like the need to go more into like the astral realm and take you now and take them when it was happening, and having a meet, and we'll see what happens when we're there.
Okay,
so I'm seeing you're standing, and I see one woman in particular walking forward, and she's coming up to meet you, and she's really small, like in size, but also demeanor. She feels like hunched over. She feels like she's hiding or not taking up space. Mm-hmm. She's not taking up space. Okay, so what are you going to do? Oh, and like you open your arms and you're bringing her into a hug. It feels like she was never truly loved and accepted. It feels like she was always told exactly how she's expected to be and formed to be that person. Because if she wasn't that person, she was physically and emotionally hurt. So mm-hmm. she was harshly hammered into this box. She wasn't able to get the nurturing love and support. So... Mm-hmm. You're giving her that nurturing love and support, that nurturing part of you that is so strong, just radiates out. And from your heart, this pink light energy is completely surrounding both of you. And as it's getting closer and sinking further into you, it's fully going into her, and she is turning into this pink light, and the pink light is swirling and then becoming part of you. And every time that you speak your mind, every time that you stand up for what you feel is right, every time you walk outside of the boxes that you have been put into, she is healing and she is growing. And she is experiencing everything that you are. And she is thanking you and giving you so much gratitude for bringing her along in this journey and helping her heal.
Wow. Okay. Thank you.
I can feel, you're welcome. I can feel her in your heart and your solar plexus. And any time that you feel that maybe you shouldn't walk out of the box, think of her and doing it for her.
That's beautiful. Thank you.
You're welcome. Oh, okay. Let's work on moving some of this energy here. Ooh. Okay. My ears were just buzzing. I'm like, whoa. Okay. All right, let's see what else. Okay, wow, that got like your sacral and root like so calmed down so much. It was a huge difference after that, but there's still, I feel a lot of the inflammation still there. It just feels like it took a dive down in that area. Mm-hmm. It was able to move more freely. Oh, and then yeah, the inflammation, like it feels around your belly button. It feels like it goes out quite far, the energy from that. Let me see what that is. Oh, okay, so this is the past life one. I'll dive into it first. I just got an image of how you died, so I'm just gonna,
ooh, I'm curious.
It was like, yeah, I saw like a giant like sword like hitting you right there.
Oh my god,
like, oh my, that's traumatic. Let's see more information around that. You were in a battle. Oh, it feels kind of like Viking. Feels you were that kind of warrior. Like the way you look feels very Viking to me. Let me see. And you were caught off guard. You were surprised. And it wasn't the fact that you were dying. It's the fact that you were surprised by death. That was the part that like got you. You were just like, oh, you wanted like, it's, if you knew it was coming and you did your best to fight it, but you couldn't, you could live with it. But because it was a surprise, you didn't see it coming. That just like, oh, draw, like you're just so frustrated with yourself for not seeing it. Okay.
Was I a man?
Yes, you were a man. Yeah. You're a very typical alpha male in that life.
Wow.
You're very strong. You were very good at fighting. You were one of like, you're part of the army, but like, you were like, you were very confident in your skills. Let me see what.
I wonder how it's related to acne.
Yeah, it's like, we'll find out. Because it feels like, I was kind of going around the inflammation line. You see, you're being hard on yourself. You were, let me see, I had it for a second. Let's go. What? Yes. Bringing awareness. Feels like when you were in battle, you had a moment of distraction. It feels like you got carried. You, for example, looked at a bird and you saw its beauty and you connected with the bird and you lost sight of the physical realm and the physical got you. It feels like this inflammation is a way to keep you in the physical. If you have pain, it keeps you, or something wrong with your physical body, it keeps you at a lower density. It keeps you grounded. It keeps you from floating too high and getting distracted. It's like, and then the acne is just a signal, a sign of the inflammation. It's all connected. And once the inflammation is dealt with, the acne will start to like clear away. It just feels like it's like the canary in the gold and in the mine, where that's the part that you notice. Mm-hmm. It's not the deep section. Okay, so how can we heal this energy, heal this wound, move forward? For you yourself, doing a lot of gold light healings around your abdomen is going to be helpful. Like I can just picture golden lights circling, surrounding like a cloud, like a donut cloud around your abdomen and continually moving. And then like it circles and then you let the energy flow out from your feet into the earth. And then the energy comes in through your crown. It circles around your abdomen and then goes out through your feet and into the earth and continue to do that. And you can keep it on your abdomen as long as you like. Before you circulate it, but that's going to help move that energy. But let's see what we're going to do right now. Okay. That's just something on your own you can do. So part of it's we need to tell that life that it's now you are safe to be in the clouds. It's safe to connect with nature. It's safe to almost disconnect from your body momentarily and live in this divine world, not just drawn down to the lower physical densities. So we need to, how can we tell that life? Because he's really stubborn. He really is like, no, this killed me. just like, fine. He's just suggesting some things, seeing Okay. He would be more willing to accept that and let that go if he was an active member or active participant in your life. As in, he was in charge of something. Like, feels like he's a warrior. He's a protector. We can give him a job to do to keep him occupied, so he's not using his energy to keep you low. So okay. We need to give him another job.
I would love to have some protection. Mm-hmm, or like, warrior. I kind of need more warrior energy because I'm more like yin energy right now, you know?
Right. Ooh. Where does he want to go? The first thing I thought of was heart. Let me just see if he has any other ideas. I want to use him on your voice.
Oh, so yeah.
Bring him in there.
Great.
Yeah. He was a warrior. He had a battle cry. He fought for him and his village. He was fearsome. He had a very strong heart, but it also felt kind of closed. So I don't want to fully bring him into your heart. But a part of him that we can fully release without any restrictions is in your voice.
Okay.
Okay. So let's see. So I'm just taking his energy. Right now it is in your abdomen. Like, I feel it by your belly button. I'm taking his energy. And as I'm moving it to the new spot, I'm going to be cutting the cord to the old spot. Okay. Okay, so there's a little bit of a caveat for the voice. He likes to be used. He likes to be useful. So calling upon him when you feel like you can't use your voice will help you use it more. And the more you can use your voice without calling him or calling him, as long as you're using it, he's going to be happy and content, because it feels like if he gets bored, he might try to travel back.
Do you know what his name is?
Names are kind of a tricky thing for me. Starts with an A. It's really weird.
I could just call him A.
Like, it's like, it has like some weird syllables, like ek, or it's got some clicks or like something weird in it.
Okay.
That I can't pronounce. I get these weird feelings. And names tend to be a little hazy for me.
Yeah, they are. Okay.
Let me see. He feels a lot like a kid. He's got really high energy and very excited, but he also gets bored. But you can utilize him without actually talking to anybody. You can sing, you can just do like make noises anytime that you want to release energy and use your voice. Just make, you can use like mantras, or you can just make noise, and that is utilizing his energy to move your blocks.
Okay.
So use your voice, experiment. I feel like just be more loud. Even if it's just around yourself, be more vocal.
Okay.
And that will keep him occupied and busy, and using his power to help move your energy, because your voice is very powerful for moving energy. So it's going to be very beneficial for you as well as him. So
okay. Wow.
Okay, let's see. Yeah, and that's going to take care of a lot of the acne stuff, but that's something that's like, it's more of like the surface. It's not the deep. Okay, let's see if there's anything for insomnia.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Let's see. Okay. So like, there's definitely a past life that's connected. There's a few. And it's like, it's fear of sleeping. Like, it feels like you have had children in the past, as well as you yourself have died in their sleep.
Oh.
So it's just a fear of sleep where it's like staying alert. And that feels like that energy from that guy where it's like, I need to be alert and on call and on defense. So there's some of that mixed in. Okay, let's see. Yeah, and it feels like the energy for the insomnia is more so in your solar plexus. Like it feels like it has trouble shutting down. It's staying active, which makes it harder to sleep.
It's not really my mind. Mm-hmm. It's, people are like, oh, you can't shut off your mind. And I'm like, no, I can. I'm just like laying there waiting.
It's not happening.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So let's move some of this and see what I can move. Okay, so I feel like, do you do like a ritual or something before bed, other than just brushing your teeth?
Not really.
Okay, I feel like creating a safe place, safe place ritual before bed is going to help convince your solar plexus and convince those lives that it is a safe place to sleep, to shut down, to remove your guard. I feel like crystals are going to be great. Like I'm really drawn to like obsidian, black obsidian.
Oh, okay.
And shungite. Those are coming up the most to help create this energetic safe place. Putting up like an energetic bubble around your bed or around your bedroom helps keep that safe unconditional love energy inside. Let me see what else. Okay, and then I'm just taking those lives and putting them into balls of energy, thanking them for keeping you safe, keeping you from having the same fate that they did. And I'm forming them all into one ball. And then I'm taking it over your solar plexus. And then I feel like I need to cut the cord and throw that energy into the ethers. Then I'll work on healing the cord. Yeah, the cord goes down to like your toes.
Wow.
It was just like affecting your whole body. You're just like, I'm awake. Let me see. And like, I'm using a lot of pink energy to heal that right now. A lot of love. And I feel like bringing in into your safe bubble, making sure that it's filled with unconditional love energy, like it's source energy, And that's going to feel the safest. So you have your protection, but the inside, filling it with gratitude for your day, and see if there's anything else. And lots of grounding as well.
Okay.
So making sure to ground before bed is also going to be very helpful, because it just wants to have all this energy in your body. So we're grounding it, we're draining all that energy, and we're bringing in the unconditional love to help calm the body and keep it and let it fall asleep.
Okay.
And bringing in your angels, your guardian angels, to help with the process is going to be good, because they can help keep this area safe. They can protect it, and they can also bring in the unconditional love. So they can play a really big part of this if you choose.
Okay.
Let me see if there's another thing. No, that feels like it's, that's going to have a big chunk of it. That's going to be that's the biggest problem. That's the biggest impact, is the protection and then the love and the grounding.
Okay.
So give that a shot.
I will. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, and now we'll work on the move. Okay, so. Oh, interesting. I'm getting a pull to South America.
Which, really?
Yeah. I'll reframe my question, because maybe the question wasn't clear.
Wait, I want to make sure it's including me and my husband.
Good.
Maybe thank that's
you.
It.
I just said you.
Okay. So me and my husband.
Okay. Okay. Yes, that made a difference.
Now I know where to go if I get divorced.
We're just on vacation.
Yeah.
Yes, I would confirm that your intuition is right. California area is going to be a good match. It's just like circling that so well. It's like, yeah, I love that area.
Any particular place, like Southern California, the Bay Area?
Okay, I don't really know the areas that well, but okay. let's see. Oh, you named places, and then I'll just say yes or no.
Okay, so I recently got an intuitive hit that a place called South. It's right next to.
I got a yes, but it's not a gigantic yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Another place is in the area, like where. California.
That's a much bigger yes.
Okay. And this is nearby. We're kind of thinking of either one.
Oh yeah, that's a good yes too.
Okay.
That's actually giving me more motion than the last one.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Does that mean it's a stronger yes?
That's stronger yes. That's a more of that's more of like a hell yes. So that's a much closer match.
Okay.
To what you want, you guys want, both of you together.
Yeah. Okay. And lastly, we really like area. So that was.
Yeah, that's a yes, but it's not as big as the last one.
Okay.
So all our yeses, they all work. It's just that one is just like more.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see. Is there more questions around relocation, or should I go back to, okay, yeah.
Like when would be the right time? We're thinking next summer, but we don't really know how to make it happen. Like how do we get from here to there, mm-hmm. especially money-wise and job-wise?
Okay, so I'm getting around like 8 months.
8 months.
8 months, maybe 9 months, like
from now.
Yeah. Oh, that also showed me it's like that's like an early time, and then it's also moving. It's like it could be later. I feel like, but like the earliest, as of right now, the energy right now. You know, of course, things can change as things move. But between 8 and 12 months is a nice window.
Okay.
Let me see. And it feels like it's not going to fall into place until closer to like 6 months or so from now, or start to come to place where you can start to kind of see little bits of how it's possible. And it's going to kind of more trickle in. It's not going to be a big whoosh.
Okay.
But you're not going to see that much insight or see how it's even possible until at least like 6 months. It feels like the last little bit is going to come together quickly.
Do you think it's like a job offer? Like my husband will need a job there, or a remote job in Canada that he can move away from?
And it feels like more like a job offer, like a physical job there, or if it is remote, it's a job that requires them to be there, maybe, is the closer to what it is. Mm-hmm. It doesn't feel like it's a job you get here and then you can just move anywhere in the world.
Okay.
Let me see. And that's for your husband. That's not necessarily for you. Your job is 100%. It's a good portion remote. I don't want to say 100% remote because I was going to say 100%. It was like, no. there's a good chunk of it that's remote. So the remote part won't be affected while you build up the physical part at the move. But it feels like you can carry the remote part and spending the time to focus a chunk of time on the remote part of your business, so that you can carry that forward.
Yeah.
And it doesn't feel like it's a full portion. Like there still needs to be a good chunk that's physical.
Okay.
But just to be aware that you need to cultivate this remote part of your business and nurture it. Give it lots of love because it's going to be the part that's carrying you through the next while.
Yeah. Yeah. That's validation. That's what I kind of figured it would be because most of my work is remote now, but I'm starting to move a little bit more into in-person stuff. So
oh, perfect.
I think it's kind of like what you're saying. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay. Let me just, is there more specific questions that you want to ask?
I don't think so. Is there any just like more guidance about the relocation or anything else that comes forward?
Okay, so I first just asked, is there anything you need to know? And they just showed me a picture of you with angel wings.
Oh, wow.
You can go anywhere your wings take you. You're not tethered. And that's with all aspects. Even when you are in one location, you're not tethered to a certain idea or tethered to a certain belief or job or anything in this world, you are not tethered to it. You can choose daily what you want to do and they can change and that's okay. So experiencing each day by just asking what you want to do this day, pretty much. What should I do? Ask for guidance of what you're going to do. and being really present and letting the energy flow through you, and you'll notice that you're you're quite varied, and that's okay. And it's okay to change regularly depending on your energy, your mood, the people you're around, and your beliefs as they're changing. And it's a beautiful thing to be so fluid. So don't tether yourself. Don't tie yourself down. Let your wings, allow them to soar. Don't clip them. Don't tie them down. Let them guide you and let you flow with what your soul wants you to do.
Okay.
So let's see if there's anything else here. Oh, a little thing about the insomnia. The guy in your throat, Mr. A, if it feels like he's a good way of releasing all this extra energy. So before bed, doing some sort of chanting or loud breathing, like big sighs, or just making guttural noises. Making noises is a good way to release that energy, and he can help you expel that before bed to help you sleep better.
Okay. So that's
another thing you can try. Let me see. He's kind of funny. Because I was still kind of connected to him, but I was going on to like the acne, the skin, and he was just like, it kind of reminded me of like the old like Bushman, be like, put some like bear cream on that. Or I'm just like, what is going on? But like, this is so odd. It feels like there's some herbs and some creams that you can apply to help soothe it and help draw the inflammation out. And I feel like you can draw the inflammation out of your body using different oils and different herbs and different like plants. I don't have a list of plants in front of me, and I don't know a lot about them. Let me see. Okay, so one that was brought up that I know about is dandelion. But there, I feel like there's most likely better ones. I will go through a list and see which ones I'm drawn to and send them to you. But I need to have them in front of me in order to like pick.
Yeah.
It's not on the top of my head. I don't have a vast plant knowledge.
Okay.
Let me see. And I think that'll be good because you can make like a salve or just like a compress to help.
Or like a face mask or something.
Yeah, something to like release, help it flow and help it release. Because it feels like it's a little stagnant. And I feel like those will also work in your abdomen to help move the energy. So it can be like multiple places for the same stuff because they're all related. When I send you the email with the recording, throat guy, what do you want to say? Stop me. I'm just like, what?
He is an alpha, isn't he?
Letting me know. Yeah. It's more than just the herbs. It's about like what you're using to hold the herbs. It's not just like chopped up herbs and put on. Like there's like oils and stuff. That's just as important.
Okay.
So I'll get my lists out and I'll figure out what he wants.
Yeah.
What he suggests, and then just what might work for your energy to see if, and then of course, like if you have issues with any of those plants, like spot test them before you put them on, make sure there's no allergy and whatnot. Don't just like cover your whole body with them just in case.
Just in case he's wrong.
Yeah, you know, like.
Okay.
That feels a lot better. Everyone seems a lot more happy. Energy is a lot more calm. More able to flow. Okay. Well, thank you so much for
wow.
having a session with me.
Thank you.